of the past. If you shed it like a piece of glass.
Thank you. Almighty ever-living God, whom taught by the Holy Spirit, we dare to call our Father. Bring, we pray, to perfection in our hearts the spirit of adoption as your sons and daughters, that we may merit to enter into the inheritance which you have promised. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the first book of Kings. Elijah went a day's journey into the desert until he came to a broom tree and sat beneath it. He prayed for death, saying, "This is enough, O Lord. Take my life, for I am no better than my father's." He lay down and fell asleep under the broom tree. But then an angel touched him and ordered him to get up and eat. Elijah looked, and there at his head was a birth cake and a jug of water. After he ate and drank, he lay down again. But the angel of the Lord came back a second time, touched him and ordered, "Get up and eat, else the journey will be too long for you." He got up, ate and drank. Then, strengthened by that food, he walked 40 days and 40 nights to the mountain of God, Horeb. The word of the Lord.
The goodness of
not grieve the Holy Spirit of God, with which you were sealed for the day of redemption. All bitterness, fury, anger, shouting, and reviling must be removed from you, along with all malice. And be kind to one another, compassionate, forgiving one another as God has forgiven you in Christ. So be imitators of God as beloved children, and live in love as Christ loved us and handed himself over for us as a sacrificial offering to God for a fragrant aroma. The word of the Lord.
Anybody else like bread?
of Italian restaurants because before the antipasto comes, I've eaten two loaves of bread. And then we always say the same thing, oh, we're not going to be able to eat the meal. Sure we can. You'd be amazed how much we can consume. And bread is a powerful symbol from ancient times. Do you ever think the first person who made bread? Oh, I know. Let's get this wheat and smash it between two rocks and make it into flour. I wouldn't have thought of that. And then let's get yeast and knead this together. I wouldn't have thought of that. And then bake it. It's an amazing thing, Brent, if you think about it. And the first person to say, hey, I understand popcorn. You had a bag of corn next to the fire and start to pop. But to get to bread from wheat, it's an amazing thing. And yet, bread is a very powerful symbol. Our readings today talk about bread. Our first reading today is about the prophet Elijah. Now, you know, we got to remember that we know our stories. We know about Aunt Bee and Andy, and we know about Spock and Captain Kirk, and we know about the Brady Bunch and Marsha. Those are the stories we know. But sad to say, we don't know our Bible stories like we do those. And so we need to know the backstory of today's first reading. So we need to know about Elijah. Now, what we need to know about Elijah is he exists during the time of Jezebel. We all heard the name Jezebel. There was a 1930s movie with Betty Davis. Kay remembers that. And it was called Jezebel. But you know what? We have this image of Jezebel as what? A harlot, right? She was a harlot. But if you know the story of Jezebel, she wasn't a harlot at all. She was a very faithful wife. Now, she did wear makeup, which I don't know. That's my mom used to say, a little makeup and paint make a woman what she ain't. But anyway, Jezebel did wear makeup. And so, but Jezebel was a Phoenician princess, and she married Ahab, the king of the northern tribe of Israel. Now, the reason why she's called a harlot is because she was a Baal worshiper. So she was not Jewish, she did not worship Yahweh, the God of Israel. And if you are not in a covenant relationship with the God of Israel, you're a harlot. Because the relationship between God and God's people is that of a marriage relationship. But she was a faithful wife. But she did bring with her all of her prophets and priests, etc., so forth. And so Elijah challenges all the prophets and priests of Baal and the prophets and priests of Asherah, Canaanite God. And he challenges them and says, you know what, let's see how great your God is. I want your God to take up this sacrifice of this bull. And so they chop up the bull and they place it on wood kindling. And the Canaanite and the Baal priests and prophets pleaded and begged, even cut themselves for their God to show his power. Nothing happened. So then Elijah, little nastiness going on here, he says, okay, let's put out the wood, let's dig a trench around it, let's put the bull on it, and let's even douse it in water. Well, you know, if you douse it in water, it's really hard to make a fire. But I'm going to show you how powerful my God is. And so they douse it with water, and sure enough, Yahweh, the God of Israel, sends down fire and sucks up that bowl. Wow. People were mighty impressed. And so And he says, enough is enough. Just kill me. I can't do this anymore. I'm over it. I'm done. Anybody else ever feel that way? I know Vinny says that every day about Joanne. No. I can't do this anymore. Actually, Joanne says it about Vinny. I can't do this anymore. I'm done. I'm done. Carol, a respiratory therapist, taking care of all the sick COVID people. Every day, you probably say, God, I can't do this anymore. I am done. I'm done. You know, so many of us are taking care of our parents, or taking care of our spouse, or taking care of our children who've come back home, or whatever. And we get tired. A day's journey into the desert. We're done. You know, so many people in the prosperity gospel genre are like, oh, I am so blessed. You know, I have health, I have wealth, I have a perfect family. And you would think that Elijah would be blessed. He called down God, and God listened, and he's connected, and all those wonderful things, and yet here he is, sitting under a broom tree in despair. Enough is enough. Praying for death. At that moment, God comes to him. Sends him an angel and says, eat! Eat and drink. Elijah wakes up, he was sleeping, and he eats and he drinks. And he goes back to sleep, because you know, right? After you eat, what do you want to do? Take a nap. He goes back to sleep. And again, the angel Lord comes in and says, have some bread and drink, because you need to be nourished for the journey. And so at his most difficult time, God did not abandon him. God is with him. And he eats, and he drinks, and he journeys for 40 days more to Mount Horeb, Mount Sinai. And then we know the story about Elijah on Mount Sinai, when he's there and he's looking to find God and meet God. And remember the story? He's not in the fire. He's not in the wind. He's in the small, you know, the rest of the story. So that's our first reading today, and that's the backdrop for today's gospel reading. You know, the church chooses the first reading because it's got some kind of, maybe sometimes loose, but a connection with the gospel. Now, as you heard, this is the gospel of John, and you might be saying, well, what should I talk about? The gospel of John, aren't we in the year of Mark? Like, yeah, well, Mark is the shortest gospel, and we intersperse John's gospel throughout this year. So, this summer, we've been reading what is called chapter 6 of John's Gospel, the Bread of Life Discourse. We are mindful that John's Gospel is the last one to be written. We have to be mindful that John's community was rejected, by the time John writes, his community was rejected by the synagogue. So they are thrown out of the synagogue. And as I've told you before, if you say, you know, you're fired, you don't say, okay. You say, you can't fire me because I quit. Okay? So the reality is, in John's community, you can't throw us out because we're gone. You can't throw us out of the synagogue because we don't need you. You don't get it. And so whenever we're reading John's gospel, we have to put that in the backdrop, because I know people might need to say this, but John is rather anti-Semitic. He's got lots of issues after being thrown out of the synagogue. Very much. When we have an interfaith service, and we have Muslims and Jews and Baha'i, but because we have Jews there, we really never can read from John's gospel. Because it's always kind of nasty to the Jews that are present. It's like, well, that was then, this is now, okay. So anyway, we have to keep that in the back of our mind. We have to be mindful that John rewrites the Hebrew scriptures in the context of Jesus. In the beginning, God said, in the beginning was the Word. We're mindful that John's gospel connects Jesus most with the divine. It's in John's gospel where we hear the I am statements. I am is God's name. And so we hear, I am the good shepherd. I am the bread of life. I am the vine, you are the branches. I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. I am, I am, I am. And so in John's gospel, we connect Jesus to the Father. We also have to keep in mind that the mission of Jesus in John's gospel is, for God so loved the world, he sent his only Son, that all who believe in him might have eternal life. That is the underlying message of the gospel. It's about believing in Jesus. And when we talk about believing in Jesus, it's not so much an ascent of the mind, but it's an ascent of the heart. It's an ascent of our lives. It's about not just words, oh yeah, I believe in Jesus. It's about my life responds in faith to Jesus. Not what I think, but what I say and what I do. That's the challenge. And so we are mindful that John's gospel is about eternal life. It's the gospel where the old water is changed into the new wine. It's the gospel where he says to the woman of Samaria, I will give you living water. It is the gospel about eternal life. Life to the full, and what that means. Today's gospel passage from John 6, what we call the Bread of Life Discourse, starts off, we remember that just a few weeks ago we heard about the multiplication of loaves, and we were mindful that then, as now, the community was divided. There were Gentiles and Jews, there were rebels and Romans, and there were just as much division then as there is now. And so we heard how the boy gave what he had. You see, people were in search of wholeness. They were in search of God. And so they went out and they followed Jesus. And they were so eager to find what they were looking for, which is what we're looking for. Meaning, wholeness, joy, peace. I don't know. That's what I'm looking for. And they were looking for that, but they didn't bring enough food. And so Jesus feeds them. And the boy gives his 5 loaves and 2 fish. The boy gets it. He gives what he has. And there's more than enough. Wow. We believe in a God of abundance, not a God of lack, not a God where there's not enough, but a God where we have eternal life, where there's more than enough. Do we trust? And so now, today's story, we pick up, and, you know, after he feeds them, what do? They start murmuring. Brings us visually back to the deserts, when the Jews, the Israelites, actually at that time, Israelites, escaped out of Egypt, and they are hungry in the deserts. And so what do? They complain. Right? They didn't like to complain. See, Jews are very much like Italians. Only Jews have a better sense of humor. We love to complain. Okay, we love to complain. And so they're murmuring and they're complaining. And so God feeds them with bread. Bread from heaven. Manna. And what do? They complain. Better we should have died as slaves in Egypt than starve to death in the deserts. Murmuring and complaining. It's today's gospel. As it picks up with murmuring. You see, it's very anti-Jewish. You're a bunch of murmurers, he's saying. And not only says that, but he says, you know what? You don't get it, and you're never going to get it. Because God is the one who will give it. And you've rejected God. Remember, this is written after that. So we hear now that they say, how can this guy say he's bread from heaven? The bread from heaven is the manna. The bread from heaven is from God. We know where this guy came from. This is Jesus. He's the son of Mary, the son of Joseph. Where does he get off? Who the heck does he think he is? Saying he's the bread come down from heaven. And yet St. John wants to say to us, he is the bread of heaven. And God does not Elijah during our rough times. He doesn't abandon us in our difficulties, but rather he's with us. And when we believe in him and respond to him, we have eternal life. Now, as you know, I pray these readings every week, and I needed to hear them. Because if you've followed our parish on Facebook, you know we've had a lot of death. I mean, I told everybody to wait till I got back, and I didn't know you were going to take me so literally. But, you know, we've had so many deaths in our parish this past week. And, you know, I know you don't understand, but I love you. I know you don't know this, but I love you. And when you die, a piece of me goes with you, and a piece of me dies with you. And I know I make it look easy and fun, but it's not easy and it's not fun. And I'm like, oh, enough. Enough. Enough is enough. And yet, I was reminded that we're not alone, that he's with us. Rennie, who sits where Walt is, Rennie, he wore a football jersey every week to church, and he was a person who actually was the bread of life. He went with Trish and James every Sunday to feed the hungry on North Street. That's, James and Trish, your inspiration. That's what it means to have eternal life. That's what it means to say yes to the bread of life. That's what it means to believe, is to become the bread of life to a hungry world. Our gathering song, we're made to glow in the dark. That's what it means to glow in the dark. That's what it means to be the bread for the world who's hungry. That's what it means to have eternal life. Today's gospel, John reminds his community and reminds our community that yes, God is with us. God nourishes us. God gives us the food for the journey. The journey isn't all roses and happiness and wonderful. The journey at times can be very, very difficult. It can be difficult as we take care of a spouse with Alzheimer's, or we take care of a spouse with cancer, or we take care of a child who's addicted to drugs, or we're with a child who's in prison and we're visiting them. The journey's not always easy. And yet we don't go alone. Jesus is the bread that came down from heaven, that nourishes us on our way. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Let us come before our God with these our needs.
For all who hunger and thirst in our community, our nation, and our world, that in this world of plenty, we be generous with our daily bread, that we unconditionally nourish all God's children with abundant justice, dignity, and life, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our brothers and sisters who have been evicted or facing eviction from their homes, that the actions of those in power be guided by the loving justice of God, and that they take action to protect the dignity of all human life, making available the resources needed to maintain a healthy and happy life. of the COVID vaccine, embrace it graciously, and continue to selflessly protect the most vulnerable in our community. For our brothers and sisters in the poorest communities of the world, that their leadership work to provide the vaccine to all in need. Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray. Lord, hear our prayer.
For those of us who work with and around those infected or affected by the coronavirus, that they feel our loving support in their daily tasks, and that they receive the peace and rest they need to rise up each new day. As they continue to love the God they cannot see by loving the neighbor they can, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, Officer Justin White, Karen Iacocca, Pa Bob Powell, William Sheridan, Frank DeGeorge, Byron Romer, Elizabeth Freeberg, Susan Mosco, Louisa Junker, Oki Okoniwiski, Renee Paquette, and Audrey Belica, all those who have died from the COVID-19, and all who have died, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, we come before you with these our needs through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Matters come tonight.
Lord, to accept the offerings of your church, for in your mercy you have given them to be offered, and by your power you transform them into the mystery of our salvation. Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
With your
spirit. Lift up your hearts.
Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer to live like us in all things but sin, that you might love in us what you loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours that by sinning we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins." Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. All glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. We live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
With your spirit.
Let's offer each other the sign of peace. Thank you.
May the communion in your sacraments that we have consumed save us, O Lord, and confirm us in the light of your truth. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Basically, I have just one announcement, and that is everything is canceled. Well, we were supposed to have a new parishioner dinner, we were supposed to do this and do that, but with the positivity rate as high as it is for our at-home church, Florida, we are like leading the nation. Anyway, until that positivity rate goes down, we're going to just really encourage people to stay home and wear masks, and if you're not vaccinated, please get vaccinated unless you have a health condition, but otherwise, we really encourage you. Our Pope said, unless you have a health condition, it's your ethical responsibility to be vaccinated. So just keep that in mind. But really, we really do want to beat this virus. And the best way is if we just don't get it and then we don't spread it. Actually, if everybody stayed home for 14 days, we'd be done. But that's not going to happen. So please, be safe. But again, everything is postponed. I do hope that September 19th we will be having Back to Church Sunday, because this variant can sometimes peak and then go down. That's what happened in England and in India. So I'm hoping by September 19th. So still be thinking about who you can invite back to church for Back to Church Sunday. We do plan on hopefully being able to be more back by then. We'll see what happens. We'll play it by ear. Okay, so anyway, we'll see what happens, but really for the time being, because the positivity rate is so high, please stay home, please stay safe, and the Lord be with you. And Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And I think 5 funerals this week is more than enough. Thank you.